So, hello, welcome back. Today, finally, at least the first part, because my maiden voyage is still on its maiden voyage. We talk about or do the shootout of the beautiful, fantastic Eric Dolphy Out to Lunch. We compare this classic series release from Blue Note with my Music Matters Jazz 45 RPM edition, and against the 75th anniversary release, and we go into that in a minute. Before we do that, I really like to discuss or give you my opinion and discuss in the comment section new announcement for the second batch of the classic series Blue Note did some days ago. And I think it's quite interesting, and maybe before we talk about it, we go briefly through the announcement, which titles they announce, and it starts on October the 1st with Duke Pearson, Merry Old Soul. Then we have Horace Silver, Six Pieces of Silver, together with Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers, The Big Beat. Then in November we will have Donald Byrd, Places and Spaces, Bobby Humphries, Fancy Dancer, both from the mid-70s. In December we will see Jimmy Smith, Home Cooking, and Ruben Wilson, Love Bug. Both are earlier. The Jimmy Smith is from 58 and the Ruben Wilson is from 69. Then again we have in December, we will see if they really do that, Herbie Nichols, The Prophetic Herbie Nichols, Volume 1 and 2, 1955. Kenny Cox, Introducing Kenny Cox and the Contemporary Jazz Quintet, 1968. In 22, we will see in January, Jackie McLean, Destination Out. Don Cherry, Where is Brooklyn? Both from the mid-60s. Then on February, we have Joe Henderson, Inner Urge, 64, and Lee Morgan, Caramba, 68. On March 22, we will see Cassandra Wilson, Blue Light Till Dawn, 1993. And also we will have Gary Allen, 21, 1994. On April the 15th, we have Milt Jackson with John Lewis, Percy Heath, Kenny Clark, Lou Donaldson and the Thelonious Monk Quintet from 1948 to 1952. And we have Bud Powell, Time Waits, the amazing Bud Powell Volume 4. Okay, what do we make with this list? In a nutshell, my opinion is that's not the classic series anymore. This is a step back to the 80s series. Just remember, we had 1 month not long ago, we had Idle Moments, Grant Green, Kenny Burrell, Midnight Blue in one batch. I can't find those huge war horses in that list. A few of them, of course. But that's not the classic series anymore. To me, that's, as I said, from the titles they have chosen, this is back to the 80s. Is that bad? No. It is surprising, but it's not that bad. Why do they do that? Of course, I have no idea. I just have a hunch. Maybe, you know, they created something with this classic series. They have a perfect image. They have had their quality problems, of course. But besides that, the titles, they gave this series the spirit. And now they drag other titles into the series to give them that spirit. Maybe that's one explanation. On the other hand, my point still is, and I get all the other points, and they are all right, but I would love to see them all again as tone poets. I think it was sound-wise, at least sound-wise, the wrong decision to do them over at Optimal. I'm very sorry to say that, but for me that was the wrong decision. I think that RTI or Palace would have done a much, much better job. But who am we? Who am I? So it doesn't matter. It's just my two cents. I don't start with the covers, with the jackets. I get that. They should be very reasonably priced, what they are. And still, I am very happy that they put out these releases, that we have to that we have the great opportunity to get those albums, those beautiful albums, easily, and don't have to look out and watch and find them. And they still, and I'm quite sure that they do, they keep the standard, and the standard is very, very, very good. Very good. I'm quite happy. I was on the lucky side. So I've read, for example, in the Hoffman forums that quite some people got really, really, really warped up records, which of course is not acceptable at all. I was on the very, very lucky side. I didn't get an album so far in the classic series that I have to return. Okay. And that now leads us to Eric Dolphy, Out to Lunch. This came out a couple of days ago. I got my copy not that early this far. This Out to Lunch is one of my favorite jazz albums. I think a lot of you do agree that this is a fantastic album, which was recorded in 1964. And we have Freddie Hubbard on the trumpet. We have Eric Dolphy on the alto sax, flute and bass clarinet. We have the fantastic Bobby Hutcherson on the vibes. We have Richard Davis on bass and Anthony Williams on drums. The record itself is a jazz album that belongs into every jazz collection. I think there is not much room for discussion when I say that. So, and now for the brief comparison. The comparison against the 75th edition series and of course to the Music Matters Jazz. I take the record out because those session photos are always important and beautiful to look at. Here you have them. Here you have the cover art. We have quite some differences in the color this time. See, this one is much darker, has more contrast, and this color variation is my favorite, although I have to know, I don't know how the original color looks, but that besides, I like this more contrast, more darker color more. So, how does the classic series release stand up against the 75th? It smokes it. No, we don't have to talk about the 75th edition compared to this classic series release mastered by Kevin Gray, pressed over at Optimal. It's by far the better version. No doubt about it. Dead, flat, quiet, vinyl, beautiful separation, beautiful sound stage, great attack, great. And I'm so happy to say that it even stands up great compared to the 45 RPM version of Music Matters Jazz. There is still, it's still better in nuances, but this one really, really stands up against the 45 RPM version. I'm so happy that this, that I can say that for once, but chapeau, fantastic, great sounding release compared to the 45 version. The closest, by far the closest so far. Great job, and I really highly, highly recommend this version. I really hope that you all, if you order it, if you have gotten it, got such a clean copy, such a silent flat copy that I got. But this time it's almost on par, which is of course fantastic. Huge compliment. Great, great job to Kevin Gray, Blue Note and Optimal, because they pressed this thing and they did a fantastic job. If you consider the price and that it is only a 33 and a third. Great. Very happy to say that. Can't wait for the maiden voyage. Let's see how this one stands up against Music Matters Jazz, Analog Production and Vinyl Me Please out of the box set. This will be up immediately after I've got the copy, cleaned the copy and compared it to the three other versions I have. So we see that, and I hope to see you on that video again. So once more, thank you for your time. See you. Bye.